Well, under one Virginia man's farm sits the nation's largest deposit of uranium. It's worth billions of dollars.
And it could also power the Commonwealth for 75 years. Mining this natural resource would also bring hundreds of high-paying jobs to Virginia. This deposit sits 200 miles west of Hampton Roads in Pennsylvania County, Virginia. Nearby towns include Chatham and Danville.
But there's one problem with bringing this uranium to the surface, and it boils down to the water you drink. If mining goes forward, some worry a radioactive waste could flow downstream and into your home. 10 on your side's David Culver trekked across the southern part of Virginia to investigate this uranium mining debate. David?
You know, Tom, it's something most folks right here in our region likely know little about. In the next few months, Virginia's General Assembly could overturn a 30-year ban on uranium mining. The move could bring a huge boom to the Commonwealth's economy. The question is, at what cost to Hampton Roads? We began our investigation speaking with Virginia Beach Mayor Will Sessoms. This tweet clearly indicates his position. The mayor wrote, "No to uranium mining." He cites a frightening what-if scenario.
This is, you know, radioactivity in your water. And I don't think we want our citizens drinking water that has radioactivity in it.
For Mayor Will Sessoms, it's all about water. Water that flows into Lake Gaston and in turn is pumped about 85 miles into hundreds of thousands of homes.
This is the water supply for Virginia Beach and a big part of Hampton Roads. I would suggest we never, and I repeat, never want to jeopardize our water supply.
The mayor's worried about the byproduct of uranium mining, called tailings. They're the sand-like substance left over after the uranium is milled. They're also radioactive. If stored improperly, an act of nature, like a storm or earthquake, could send them back into the environment.
If, you know, these tailings got into our water, it could be a devastating event for our region.
Head west along Route 58, and you'll begin to see billboards sharing the mayor's sentiment, a campaign to keep Virginia's ban on uranium mining. The many signs target Walter Coles' land in Pennsylvania County.
When you see the signs, do you take it personal at all?
No.
Coles calls himself a farmer. He's adamant his decision to mine his own land is not about money.
Farmers are not so aggressive in the financial sense that you would think. In fact, I was offered millions of dollars to sell this farm and move that house, and I turned it down.
Turned it down to start his own company, Virginia Uranium Incorporated. It's backed by U.S. and Canadian investors. Coles wants to control how the land would be mined. After all, this property has been in his family for five generations.
At first glance, it's simple farmland, really pristine and beautiful. But don't be fooled. Under this earth sits the largest undeveloped uranium deposit in the United States. It's worth an estimated $7 billion. The thought of mining this uranium is not really sitting well with everyone in nearby Chatham.
It's scary. It is a scary thought, not knowing what it could do to you.
Well, I know the people that live in the county are really worried, concerned. You know, they're concerned about health, but they're also concerned about property value. I mean, who wants to live next to a uranium mine?
Others look at the positives, like the potential of hundreds of high-paying jobs.
These are $75,000 a year jobs. Yeah, that would be a good thing.
Another good thing, energy independence, a pressing topic in the past election, and one Virginia Uranium is focused heavily on.
We import 100% of the uranium that we need here in Virginia to fuel our nuclear reactors, and we import as a country over 90% of the uranium we need to fuel the 104 reactors around the country.
But with the potential for great reward, there's also the possibility for great risk, especially for those living downstream in Hampton Roads. Virginia Uranium's project manager, Patrick Wales, says the best way to reduce that risk is to store the tailings underground, not in above-ground chambers.
The public utilities director in the city of Virginia Beach has said that, yeah, if the company does that, it significantly reduces, if not eliminates, the concerns that they have.
Mayor Sessoms agrees it's a safer option.
Perhaps, and we've said this, perhaps we'd take that into consideration.
But as of now, he says there's no legislation guaranteeing the tailings must be buried. And even if there was, he worries it wouldn't be enforced.
I try to be a person of reason, but on this one, my heels are dug in.
So ultimately, the decision to remove the Commonwealth's ban on uranium mining is not up to the mayor or Virginia Uranium Incorporated. It's going to be up to the General Assembly. Virginia Governor Bob McDonnell has a uranium working group researching this matter. They're going to submit their report to the governor in early December. The General Assembly could take up the matter when they meet again in January. Even if the moratorium is lifted, Virginia Uranium Incorporated says it's going to be years before they even begin mining. I'm David Culver, 10 on your side.
There are a lot of moving parts, a lot of elements of this story, and you will likely want to learn more. So on wavy.com, we've set up with several web extras for you, and you can click on this story and then find out more about Virginia Uranium Incorporated. You can also learn more about uranium as a resource, plus see where exactly Virginia Beach and parts of Chesapeake and Norfolk get their water.